Today's event is titled Explore New Streamlined Enhancements in Gallo K-12 and the K-12 Student Parent Center. My name is Baron Reyna, and I'm one of the field service coordinators at Assessment Technology Incorporated. A little bit about ATI. We're a Tucson, Arizona-based company, which was founded back in 1986. We are fortunate to work with hundreds of school districts and schools and districts nationwide, all the way from Hawaii to Massachusetts and kind of everywhere in between. For today's event, we're going to be exploring the new menu bar and the new teaching dashboard. These two features were recently introduced, actually last month. Dr. Jason Fell did a great presentation prior to the release of the new menu bar and the teaching dashboard. And this is a continuation of that. And now that the menu bar and teaching dashboard have been released, I'm also going to go into the K-12 Students Parent Center, which is actually not a new feature. It was released early the calendar year, I want to say January timeframe, but many districts did not enable it, and it was enabled automatically for districts over the summer. So when your students log in at the beginning of the year, if they haven't already, they're going to be presented with a new K-12 Student Parent Center. So I wanted to give you a brief intro brief run through on how to navigate the Parent Center. And I like to take people into a test, although you've probably seen our technology and enhanced items many times. I still like to go just walk you through whenever I have the opportunity. And then finally, we'll go through the Q&A session. So let's go ahead and jump into the application. So I am actually already on the dashboard page, which is down here. But before I get into the dashboard page, I wanted to talk a little bit about the new menu bar. The new menu bar, as I mentioned, was released last month, and that basically is the portion of the screen that you see up here. The new menu bar is available. It's been streamlined. If you're familiar with Galileo in the past, we had the red tabs that were above, and you could access, you know, the features of the system through the red tabs and drill down into the specific topics you want. Now we just made it a more fluid connection to the features that you're looking for within Galileo Plus. We were able to update the interface to use responsive design and support a variety of platforms or devices. So in addition to, you know, PCs and Macs, we realized people are going to be using these on Chromebooks and tablets and who knows, even phones or something like that. So this is helpful in being able to, the change to this menu bar was helpful in supporting additional devices. You can see that we can hover over one of the areas within the system and a drop-down menu shows up, and we're able to go do different things depending on what area we're in. So if I choose the assessment area, I still want to call it a tab, so you'll have to excuse me. But you're able to access, let's say, you know, test planning, test construction, test scheduling, test administration, etc. Depending on what you hover over, you're able to come over here and choose which option you want to bring up. So if I click on Test Builder, I only have to do one click in order to get to the Test Builder page. I can just quickly move over there. And I'm presented with a Test Builder page. This is confirming I'm on the Test Builder page. This is the bar below is showing me the district that I'm associated with, the school, and the class. This is all play. This is a play area that we're in right now. If you do want to hide this, you can actually click this little minus sign. It gives you a little bit more screen real estate. You can hide that or show that as you wish. In addition, you're able to access some quick links, and there's three quick links that you're able to access. The first one being the dashboard. It looks like a little speedometer from your, you know, car dashboard. You have access to the calendar view and to the settings, so you can click on any one of those and you can access those particular pages. In addition, there are some quick links that are available if you hover over this icon at the top. It's basically just showing your initials. I'm logged in as a district administrator is what my account. Otherwise, my initials BR would show up here normally if I was logged in as myself. But again, it's a play area, so. And then you're able to access some various quick links. You can access the help files. You can access our tech support page, our forum, sitemap if you get lost and you need help finding something. You can change your password or enter an email or change your email. And then finally, you can sign out of the system from there. So that is an introduction to the new menu interface. At the same time that we introduce a new menu interface, we also introduce the new teaching dashboard. And you can access the dashboard by clicking on this link here. This is the new teaching dashboard that you see here. This is different than the new menu bar. The new teaching dashboard is not enabled automatically for districts. So when you bring up the dashboard, if you go to the old dashboard, there's usually a link here up at the top where you can preview the new dashboard. In this particular area, the new dashboard has already been enabled, and I'm able to view the dashboard here. But once the new dashboard has been enabled for your district, when you click on the dashboard, it will automatically bring you to a page that looks like this. And some of this will look very familiar to those who have used Galileo in the past. Some of this will look a little bit different. It's basically, again, been updated to be a little bit more sleek design, more user-friendly interface for the teachers whoever's using the interface. It does automatically come up to the calendar view, and that's important if you're implementing our curriculum pieces within the system or assessments within the system, because you can easily see what tests have been scheduled within the system, what units have been scheduled. We'll go back to that in a minute. But if you want a more familiar view or view to the report, view the reports that are available within the system, you could actually click on the reports view of the teaching dashboard here, and that's what I'd recommend you do. If you didn't come to the correct page, you may have multiple options to select from up here. A teacher would have a teaching view and an IE view. By default, they should automatically go to the teaching view. All right, so this is the reports view of the dashboard, and I'll just go through some of these widgets. You're able to change your settings here. So if you have access to, let's say, multiple classes, which in my case, I'm logged in as a district user, so I'm able to see multiple classes. But let's say if you're a middle school or a high school teacher and you had at multiple sections, you could change your view of your section there. If you wanted to run reports for your class, you'd leave that default class selection. Otherwise, you could choose an intervention group, which should maybe be a subset of your students that you'd be looking at for these reports over here. By the way, your district logo should show up here at the top. I have a generic one selected for my demo area, so I'm not seeing a specific district logo, but we would have that available for you. Then if you scroll down, you're able to view your class roster over to the right, and see your students that are assigned to this particular class, as well as if we have a photo uploaded for them, you're able to see that photo. You're able to see student information for the student, as well as assessment history. So we can go back, and let's say it's the beginning of the year, which it is right now, we're able to go back and look at prior year's information for the students just to get an idea of, I'm a fifth grade teacher, what is their performance in the fourth grade, third grade, et cetera, assuming you've been using Galileo. I'm able to view all students, which is the view that we have selected right now. I can view students whose birthday is today or any upcoming birthdays that we have coming up. So I'll put it back to the all view. And then in addition, I'm able to view student accounts. That is usernames and passwords. If you're accessing Galileo online or taking online tests within the system, you're able to view the student accounts through that link. You can also, assuming that you have privileges, most teachers will not have access to the enroll and drop students. That icon would appear there, and then printing a class, the option to print a class roster would also show up, and you get a nice PDF view of your class roster. This should look somewhat familiar. Recent events, we've obviously made it a little bit more enhanced the dashboard, but the basic functionality continues to be there. So I'm able to view recent assessments that have been administered in my class, and if there's older assessments, I can go back and look at prior assessments for the year. I'm able to view my reports just by clicking on any one of these links here, very similar to what we had in the previous dashboard. What what's changed is one of the things that have changed is we're pre-populating with some of the more popular information or some of the most pertinent information for the class. So we will be, you know, populating the data for whatever data we were able to find within the system. And if there's, let's say, ELA tests or math tests, science tests, writing tests, etc., those would, you know, you would change the subject to view those. And then we're also able to view the student growth and achievement report by coming down here. It automatically selected the first test I administered and the last math test that I've administered, which happens to be test number one and test number three. However, if we did want to compare different tests, we could just choose a different setting, either for our start test or end test. If we want to select a different grade or subject, we could do that there as well. And it shows us the student growth and achievement report. Nice thing about the student growth, this version of the student growth and achievement report, and if I want to drill down and see a group of students and differentiate those students a little bit better, I can drill down and I can view the information for the student. I can even drill down a little bit further if we need to, or reset the view and view all. So there's some exciting changes that have been happen with the reports view of the teaching dashboard. Then we get to the calendar view. And again, I mentioned this is kind of the default view that the teacher would see when they log into the system. I logged in as a district level user. I don't so I may not automatically come to this page, but it just so you know, a teacher, when they log into the system, they would automatically come to the teaching dashboard page unless they've changed that through the settings. But most users would not have changed that setting. So they will come to the dashboard as soon as they log into the Galileo system. So they will be presented with a page that looks exactly like this. And they're able to view their upcoming assessments or assessments that have been scheduled for the month that they have selected. They can go forward and see a different month. They can check by day, week, month, etc. by changing those settings. I can see what tests that I have scheduled in my class for this week. I can see if I've scheduled any units, if there have been any units scheduled or lessons that have been scheduled for my class, and those would show up here within the class dashboard. We've also made it very easy to go in and to build tests or build lessons within the system by coming up to the drop down up here. So if a user wants to build a lesson plan for next week, they could come into the lesson plan builder, then choose a unit they have access to, and then build their lesson plan and schedule it for the following week. That brings us to the next option, which is to schedule. They can schedule a test, schedule a lesson, schedule an assignment, and those again would show up in the calendar for either their own use or for student use. These would be assigned. These are some assignments that have been assigned to the students in this particular class. And you'll actually see that next as we jump into the K-12 Student Parents Center. So I'm already logged in. I'm going to pull up a different window. Let me just check my audio real quick, make sure. Yep. All right. So I am hooked up to the K-12. Now I am logged into the K-12 Student Parent Center. And for those of you who, let me just log out real quick. But this is the interface to log into the K-12 Student Parent Center. And I'll log in as a student, play student, obviously. So I'm logged into the K-12 Student Parent Center. This is the main interface that the students would see when they log into the system. They're able to initiate an assessment. They're able to view any assignments that the teacher has made available for them or any benchmark assessments. That's also presented in the calendar view so they can see what they have going on for that particular month, or again, they can change that view. There's also some other views that they can get access to. Okay, so some people are able to hear me fine, but I guess some users are not. But this will be posted online, so you'll be able to have access to that. So the user can, the student can go to the calendar view and view a full page version of the calendar. They're also able to access any files that the teacher has chosen to post up for them. If they want to change the school year, I don't have multiple school years that I'm at, that I have access to for this play area, but if they had multiple school years, they would show up here. If I wanted to view my profile and see that the student can see their information, their name, their date of birth, gender, obviously they have access to that, but they can view teacher information. And one of the nice things as well is they can use the Google Translate and translate the language into their home language. I'll translate it to Spanish, and you'll see some stuff transfers very well. Obviously acronyms and other things don't necessarily, so you can see that it translates over. Before I get too lost, I'm going to translate it back to Spanish, English. But this, again, this page was redeveloped for that responsive design, so it's available for multiple devices as well: PCs, Macs, tablets, Chromebooks, pretty much any computer that has a browser, one of our supported browsers. The students can change the class that they have access to. Not as important in the elementary schools, where they're usually in a self-contained class all day, but middle school and high school, where they need to change classes, they would want to change the class where they could see, so they could see the content that's been scheduled for them for that class. So as a student, I'm able to go in and view the resources that have been made available to me. This teacher scheduled a Khan Academy video, so I can actually click on that link and it will take me to the Khan Academy content. And I don't think I have my speakers turned up, but at least you can kind of see. Actually, I'll go ahead and turn on the speakers. So the student is able to watch that video. And then, once they're done, they can go back here, and there is a corresponding quiz that goes along with it, also from Khan Academy, and they could, do that quiz. So that's an example of some things they can do within the teacher dashboard, which haven't always been available, only recently available, that they could actually schedule external content, such as Khan Academy. They've always been able to get in and access our formative assessments or our benchmark assessments. I have a little sample test set up that they're able to use as well. And this one has some of our examples of our technology enhanced questions. So I'm going to go ahead and click on there. We'll spend like a couple minutes just going through some of the questions. By the way, there are other webinars that show you more in depth than I'm going in today. This is more of an overview, so you can go in and view the webinars that are specific to technology enhanced questions. As I mentioned, Dr. Jason Fell did a great job on introducing the dashboard and some of the curriculum features. We will have more to go. So I'm logged in as a student, Alyssa Acosta. This is a play area, so we've already logged in and taken this test multiple times. This is an example of a custom HTML question where the student is best plotting this inequality. So they're able to select the line that best matches that inequality, and then they can shade which side matches that inequality. This is a multiple choice assessment. It is asking for the use of a scientific calculator. There is a calculator link that's available here that the student can access, and it will change what type of calculator is available depending on the type. So we have general calculators as well as scientific and graphing calculators. The student is also able to access tools. As you can see, they strike through some of the questions, so they're able to see the strike through. They're able to add a note that is specific to this particular question, so when they come back, they can view the notes for that. This question has been marked for review, so I can unmark it. That just means that they want to come back later and check on it. And I can also turn on highlighting, which would be probably more appropriate for ELA type questions, but they can also highlight pretty much anything that is a text-based type question. This is a custom HTML question. They're supposed to transfer the contents and show the volume or corresponding volume from planter 1 to planter 2. Graph the coordinates for a point, This is our sequencing, so this can be used for math questions, for order of operations, or largest to greatest, least to greatest. It could also be used in ELA to show put in order a series of events in a story, or alphabetize a list of words, etc. Let's see, interactive text questions. And let me jump. I think I have some science-based questions that we can take a look at. Here is, they're supposed to drag these over and label the parts of a cell. There's also ones that, you know, have them identify, bones in the skeleton, etc., parts of a skeletal system, etc. Let's see, I think I have some ELA questions as well. I'm sorry, I'm jumping through these kind of quickly, but obviously, if you have more in-depth questions, you can contact your field service coordinator or view the webinars that are available. This is an example of an ELA question where they can expand the question, the text, and read the text a little bit better. And then when they want to answer the question, they can come over here. And this is an expanded multiple choice question. There are actually, two sentences that are correct. So two options that are correct out of the six options that are available. Six options that are available here. Sequencing type questions, so they're supposed to order the events, etc. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and see if there's any questions. I have about 5 minutes left of our time here. One of the questions that came in is, how is the new teacher dashboard activated? So I guess they're currently not able to see, or not defaulted at the enhanced teacher dashboard, or the new teacher dashboard. And that is a district controlled function. So you'd want to contact your district administrators to find out when or how soon the new teacher dashboard will be enabled for your district, but you can still preview it and you're still viewing the new dashboard. It's just you have to click on a different link in order to access that. How do we access the TE items or the technology enhanced items? Those are, again, that's kind of a district decision. Some districts choose to use only our multiple choice style assessments. And it's not because they don't want to use the technology enhanced questions. It's just the technology enhanced questions obviously involve some sort of technology. So computer or Chromebooks or tablets that the students would have available, and they would be able to interact with the questions. So the multiple choice questions do offer the flexibility of being able to administer it online or offline, whereas the technology enhanced questions do have to be administered online. So sometimes it's just a matter of infrastructure that is being made available. That said, if a district does choose to use the multiple choice items, we have sample tests, or play tests that you can use that are utilize the technology enhanced questions. So if you want to give your students practice with these technology enhanced questions, because they may be experiencing them with the statewide assessments, a lot of the statewide assessments are moving to the online assessments, then you can administer one of our practice assessments or build one of your own assessments using our formative item bank. And the last question I have so far is, are there any training materials available for the new menu and for the new dashboard? And I'll answer that by actually going back into the system. So now I'm switched back into the Galileo K-12 site, the staff site. So if you're logged in as a teacher, this is what you'd see. But you are able to access our help files by going to the your initials up here, the drop-down menu, and then selecting the help. And from there, you're able to view many of our help files that are available through the system. So I would encourage you, if you have not looked in here, to get in here and look at the resources that are available. A lot of them are available on this How Do I Access area, but if you don't see something that you're looking for, you can come up here to the search bar and we can just type in dashboard, for example. And then you're able to get an overview of the existing dashboard. There is step by, you know, usually there's some step-by-step instruction. In this particular case, it's giving you different options. And in the end, there may be a handout that's available as well that you can access. So these resources can be shared with your staff. So it looks like I'm right up against my time. I'm going to go ahead and stop. And I last before we end, I just want to thank you all for attending today's webinar. A recording of this webinar will be available and posted on the ATI website and our Facebook page. To schedule a personal demonstration, you can contact us at the phone number listed, you can email us, or you can go to our website and there's a link to set up a personalized webinar if you want. I encourage you, if you're hooked up on Facebook, go to our Facebook page and certainly give us a like. There's a lot of information that we share from our Facebook page. And then, as I mentioned before, this is a series in our continuing series of events, webinar. So we will be having additional webinars. The next one coming up November 3rd on our digital curriculum platform, and then January 11th on our comprehensive assessment system. Recordings of the previous events are available off of our website and can be accessed through the website at the link that is shown below. Thank you very much.